Working in distribution and or wholesale means dealing with a whole lot of data. Between sifting through all the product data you get from your manufacturers, cleaning it up and restructuring it, and then putting it together in product sheets or catalogs to send to your own clients, it's a lot of hours spent on data management. That's why in this video, I'm going to show you how product information management or PIM software can help cut down those hours of work by making your data management more efficient. Mikey with Politics here, and today we're going to kick things off with a quick overview of the tool, followed by the different distribution data it can handle, and then its different functions and the benefits they bring with them. Sound like a plan? Then let's get started. But if you do want to skip ahead at any point, there are some handy chapter links down below. The basic idea of a product information management or PIM tool is to give you one system where you can store all your data, check it for accuracy and completeness, and then get it ready to be distributed to everywhere that needs it, using automation features so you're not wasting time on duplicate work. For companies involved in distribution and wholesale, this means it'll give you one central hub where you can keep all the information you get from your manufacturers or suppliers, and where you can adapt it as necessary before sending it out to your retailers, other distributors, or whoever else needs your product data. PIM software can store pretty much any kind of data points or attributes. When it comes to the ones most relevant for wholesalers and distributors, we have the following. First things first, we've got product identifiers, so the numbers or codes that identify each of your products. Chances are you'll have SKUs or SKUs that are unique to your company, but depending on your setup, you'll probably use some more universal identifiers as well, like GTINs or UPCs. Next up, there's organizational data to help you sort your products in different ways. Some of these are simple attributes like a product's brand or the manufacturer or supplier name if you're working with multiple manufacturers and suppliers. There are things like collections and product lines as well, and then more advanced taxonomy data like categories and subcategories, parent products and their variants, or related products for things like components and accessories, or any other bundles of products that are typically sold together. Then we have all the other details about the products themselves, so product labels or titles and any other relevant individual details like color, size, material, and so on. This can include technical specifications as well, like power requirements or compatibility information, which are particularly important when distributing things like electronic goods, machinery, or parts. Technical documents can be stored within a PIM tool too, along with product images, videos, audio, and any other type of file you like, all in the same system as your data. This function basically gives you an online drive to store whatever you want, but unlike with a simple cloud drive, you can also link those files to your products to make organization easier. It has some more advanced media features too, like the image resizing or reformatting options, which we'll see in more detail later on. Of course, we can't forget about the financial side of things. You can store information about the cost of the various goods that you're getting from your suppliers, as well as the price you'll then charge to whoever you're selling them to. Or prices, for that matter. A PIM system can be a great way to keep track of any different pricing structures or promotions that you have in place for your different retailers, regions, or other customer segments. On that note, if you're sending products to multiple retail partners or other distributors, you may be dealing with needing to adapt your data for each one. In addition to varying prices and product selections, you've got things like multilingual and multi-regional data for international distribution. This includes translations, localized sizing, and regulatory compliance information specific to each region or country. Think stuff like documentation related to environmental and safety standards, which can vary massively from country to country. Also, for more information about the different types of data that PIM software can handle, check out the resources in the description for a guide to what data this software can store. So, we've gone over the different bits of data you can store in PIM software, but presumably you're already managing and storing this information in some other system or drive. So, what makes using PIM software different? Glad you asked. First up, if you're receiving data from multiple sources, I'm willing to bet that you're getting it in multiple formats and via multiple channels. Worst case scenario, you've got suppliers and manufacturers sending you product data in spreadsheets, text documents, PDFs, and other file formats via emails, Dropbox, a shared Google Drive, or even WhatsApp messages. Even if it's not as complicated as that and you've just got everyone emailing you CSVs, you're probably still going to see some different layouts within the spreadsheets themselves, since different companies work in different ways. With PIM software, you can provide all your various suppliers and manufacturers with an easy way to upload their data directly to the same system. This could be simply uploading a CSV or something automated like a file feed URL, or getting the tool to fetch data from an FTP or SFTP connection or Dropbox folder on a regular schedule. The cool thing here, though, is that no matter how they upload their data, it's all going to end up in the same system. So you can see all of it and work on all of it at the same time. Plus, you can save the upload settings and preferences for each supplier and manufacturer to speed up the process in the future. Remember that this doesn't just help with external data contributors either. This also applies to other departments or team members within your organization. PIM software gives everyone inside and outside your company a central source of truth to work from. So somewhere where they can share and access the data they need whenever necessary. You can even adjust permission settings too in order to control that access, just in case there are some parts of your data that you don't want everybody to be able to view or edit. The centralization aspect makes it way easier to make sure you have all the data you need too. When suppliers send over spreadsheets with only the bare minimum of information, it can take your team a lot of work to fill in the blanks with the rest of the product's information needed before they can send it on to wherever your products need to go. Often, this process means bugging your suppliers or other departments for more details, jumping between systems to hunt down particular data or assets, and then finally manually adding everything to wherever you're keeping your product information. It's kind of a pain in the ass. PIM software comes with features that let you track how much of your data has been completed for any particular product, so you can see at a glance what's missing. You can set these completeness trackers up for whatever data sets you like. So, for example, each of your retail partners' specific requirements, and then use them as filters for smart lists. What does all of that mean? Well, set these features up right, and you could end up with automatically generated, self-updating lists containing all the products that are ready to be sent to whichever retail partner you like. Or the opposite, a ready-made to-do list with all the products that are missing data and shouldn't be sent out just yet. Speaking of sharing data, another typical issue faced by distributors and wholesalers is the simple task of sharing data with whoever they're sending their products to. So, retailers, resellers, or other distributors. Like I mentioned earlier, and like I'm sure you've noticed, each of these will often have different data requirements, whether it's how you send them information or the content of the information itself. For example, while one retailer might want you to email them an XLSX file with their selection of products and prices, another similar retailer may want to be able to download their particular product's information on their own schedule in CSV format instead. Not to worry, PIM software's got this covered. Firstly, you've got a variety of export options, ranging from a simple CSV, XLSX, or PDF download, to a more high-tech option like a URL feed where retailers can download data directly. The best part is, though, instead of having to constantly manually create similar but different files for each of your retail partners and resellers, PIM software lets you automate the process. It can take the information that's already in your system and use it to make those files for you, based on whatever settings and preferences you establish when you first set up the export. It can even use formulas to automatically change or reformat the data on export when necessary without you needing to do it manually, or even store the adapted versions in your tool. As if that wasn't enough, it can do the same thing for your product images too. This means you can just keep one original version or master copy of your data and images in your system and get your PIM software to adapt it for different exported versions, but without having to clog up your system with loads of different, slightly similar copies. Combine all of these features, and in the end, you'll find that you're spending way less time hunting down data, that the quality and completeness of your data is through the roof, and that time to market has been slashed. Amazing what you can do with the right technology, isn't it? So that's about it for this video, but there's a lot more that could be said about this software. Check out the other resources linked in the description for more information, or better yet, get in touch with a PIM expert directly so that they can evaluate your particular situation and see if the software is a good fit. And there's a link for that in the description too. Anyway, thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and see you next time. Boing. Self 5. What?